This is an example of a gamma scan where the results indicated that tray damage was present. This is a plan view taken from the tower drawings to show the scan orientation. Radioactive source is placed on one side of the tower, radiation detector on the opposite side, and radiation was transmitted and detected through the active areas of the trays. This orientation was chosen in order to avoid any interference from the tray downcomers. This is an elevation view, also taken from the tower drawings, showing that the gamma scan started at the top tangent line, and the source and detector were lowered simultaneously down the tower to produce a density profile or a gamma scan profile. This is a density plot showing the results of the gamma scan. Low density on the right-hand side of the plot increases in density to the left. Thus, absorptions can be seen for a mist eliminator in the top of the tower and for most of the trays. Two exceptions are tray 6, which produced a less dense absorption, indicating that tray to be damaged, and tray 1, which produced no absorption, indicating that tray to be missing completely. And subsequent column entry verified these results. So in summary, the gamma scan showed that trays 9 to 7 and 5 to 2 were normal, tray 6 was damaged, and tray 1 was missing. And with this knowledge, the plant could properly plan for their turnaround, knowing they only needed to replace 2 trays rather than 8 or 9. Thank you for your time, and we appreciate your interest in tower scans.